Yo, what's up? It's D Wood coming to you on the Apostate Prophets channel. Why am I on the Apostate Prophets channel and not on my own channel? Easy. I got banned for posting statistics about Christian persecution. It's official. YouTube will no longer tolerate videos that discuss the persecution of Christians. If a Christian gets killed for her faith in Pakistan or Nigeria, you're not allowed to discuss it on YouTube. If you do, the ironically named Trust and Safety Team will give you a strike for hate speech. I got one this morning. Hi, Act-17 Apologetics. Our team has reviewed your content, and unfortunately, we think it violates our hate speech policy. We've removed the following content from YouTube. Video: Global Persecution of Christians, Disturbing Trends. In that video, I simply gave an overview of the Open Doors 2020 World Watch List, which discusses the most recent data on the persecution of Christians in various parts of the world. YouTube blocked a video that did absolutely nothing except provide some facts about the persecution of Christians. Watch how YouTube describes the content of my video. How your content violated the policy. Content glorifying or inciting violence against another person or group of people is not allowed on YouTube. We also don't allow any content that encourages hatred of another person or group of people based on their membership in a protected group. We review educational, documentary, artistic, and scientific content on a case-by-case basis. Limited exceptions are made for content with sufficient and appropriate context and where the purpose of posting is clear. So, simply reporting that 8 Christians per day are being killed for their faith somehow amounts to glorifying or inciting violence, according to the human rights experts on the YouTube Trust and Safety Team. How this affects your channel. Your channel now has one strike. You won't be able to do things like upload, post, or live stream for 1 week. A second strike will prevent you from publishing content for 2 weeks. 3 strikes in the same 90-day period will result in your channel being permanently removed from YouTube. Well, I don't know how I'm going to avoid 3 strikes in 90 days when YouTube is now handing out strikes for the hate crime of posting statistics on Christian persecution. YouTube has been banning my videos like it's a sport, but they haven't been giving me strikes. Now they're giving me strikes, which means that my channel can disappear any day. There is an appeals process, but the appeals process is absolute garbage. Appeals go to the same Antifa wannabe trust and safety morons who blocked the videos in the first place. And if you want to know how well the appeals process works, I received the strike this morning. I appealed the strike immediately, and my appeal has already been rejected. So they reviewed my video about Christian persecution twice, and they concluded twice that talking about Christian persecution is hate speech. I don't trust the Trust and Safety Team. I don't feel safe with the Trust and Safety Team deciding which speech constitutes hate speech because they seem to have absolutely no clue. A troop of monkeys pounding on buttons with bananas would do a better job of enforcing the actual community guidelines. The entire system is a pile of garbage, and I can't wait for more creators to follow Joe Rogan off the platform. That's right, YouTube. You deserve to go the way of MySpace. Your platform is popular because of content creators, and you treat content creators like we're some dog crap that needs to be scraped off the bottom of your shoe. And guess what? I could take all of that. I could take all of that. But you couldn't stop at treating us like refuse. You couldn't stop with us. You had to extend your utter contempt for others to people who are really suffering. There are people who are really suffering in this world. And in some of those places, the people who are suffering aren't exactly free to speak out on their own behalf. So they need people in other parts of the world to speak out for them. But YouTube has just declared that anyone who speaks out for them will be silenced by our narcissistic YouTube overlords. Your platform needs to die. It will not be mourned, because we'll be having too much fun on the platform that buries you. With all of that said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to keep riding YouTube until that better platform comes along. Then comes the exodus. For now, my channel is sitting on the naughty step. I made a video last night. It's about Asia Bibi's brother-in-law being murdered in Pakistan. As we've seen, that too now qualifies as hate speech on YouTube. But I posted it on my other YouTube channel. I've had another YouTube channel for a few years, but I've never posted anything on it, so it has no subscribers. It now has one video, and since I've been making videos every day, I'll probably post this week's videos on my other YouTube channel. So if you want my videos for this week, the link to my other channel, it's just called David Wood, is in the description box. If you'd like to see the Christian persecution video that YouTube dubbed hate speech, it's on my BitChute channel. The link to that is in the description box. If you'd like to contact YouTube in order to see if they can clarify their rules, since the real rules are obviously not the rules they make public, there's the Team YouTube page on Twitter where you can ask questions or share this video. Talk to you again soon, one way or another.